Hello everyone, this is Chris from Spoon Graphics, back again with another video tutorial. Today we're going to take a look at how to create a realistic watercolour painting effect in Photoshop using a bunch of filters to replicate the kind of mottled look that is produced by watercolour paints. This effect works particularly well with landscapes, which are also a popular subject for real life watercolour paintings. So we'll find yourself a base photograph and open it up in Adobe Photoshop. Duplicate the background layer twice by pressing the shortcut Command and J, then turn off the visibility of the first layer. Select the first background copy and go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Select the Dry Brush option from under the Artistic category, then configure the settings to 10 for the brush size, 10 for the brush detail, and then 1 for the texture. Hit OK, then rename this layer to Brush Marks. Turn on the visibility of the second layer, then go to Filter and Filter Gallery again. This time select the cutout effect and configure the settings to 5 as the number of levels, 4 as the edge simplicity, and 1 for the edge fidelity. Choose the blending mode for this layer to Pin Light, then rename it to Edge Bleed. Select the brush marks layer, then duplicate it by dragging it over the new layer icon or using that shortcut Command and J. Move it to the top of the layer stack and then give it the name Smart Blur. With this layer selected, go to Filter, Blur and Smart Blur, then use 5 for the radius, 100 for the threshold, and then make sure the quality is set to high. Hit OK, then change this layer to the screen blending mode, reduce the opacity to around 60%. Make a new copy of the original background layer, move it to the top of the layer stack, then give it the name Sketch Lines. Head to Filter and Filter Gallery, then under the Stylize folder select the Glowing Edges option. Change the settings to 1 for the edge width, 20 for the edge brightness, and 15 for the smoothness. Next up, use the shortcut Command Shift and U to desaturate this layer, then press Command and I to invert it. Change this layer to Multiply to render the white areas transparent, and reduce the opacity to around 60%. Press Command and A to select all, then Command Shift and C to copy merged, then paste this selection on a new layer at the top of the layer stack. Next go to Filter and Filter Gallery once again, then under the Texture category select Texturizer. Change the drop down to Sandstone, then enter 100% for the scaling, then 2 for the relief. Reduce the opacity of this layer to around 75%, then rename it to Paper Texture. All that's left then is to add a vibrance adjustment layer by clicking the adjustment layer selection at the bottom of the layers panel and tweak the settings so the vibrance is plus 100 and the saturation is minus 15 to bring out the colours of the image. So that finishes off the watercolour effect in Adobe Photoshop. The mix of filters is really what makes this effect look so realistic by reducing the detail and blending all those colours together to look like painted brush strokes. If you want to save some time, I actually have this effect available as a ready-made action, along with other artistic effects that turn your photos into painted, inked and sketched works of art. You can find a link to the download page in the description. If you enjoyed my video tutorials, I'd really appreciate a thumbs up to help spread the word. And don't forget to subscribe on YouTube if you want to be the first to see my future videos before they're published on my website. So, as always, thanks for watching. I'll catch you all later.